Hello everyone, this section of information carries the definition for cancer, type of tumors, the methods for the detection and diagnosis of the cancer, and the remedies for the cancer or treatment for the cancer. So basically, cancer is a dreadful disease. It is one of the chief killers today. It is most common in people among 40 to 60 years of age, but may occur at a younger age also. It commonly originates in the tissues in which the cells are regularly replaced by mitosis. These tissues include skin, lining of digestive tract, reproductive organs, lungs and liver. Normally, the cells of a given tissue divide at a certain fixed rate and in a controlled manner. For instance, the cells lining the gut are replaced completely every 36 hours. Skin cells every few days and red blood corpuscles every few weeks. Sometimes more reasons not clear yet, mitosis occurs in these tissues at rates far above the normal and in an uncontrolled fashion. This results in an abnormal growth called tumor or neoplasm, which means new growth. In cancer of white blood corpuscles, which is known as leukemia, no tumor is formed. So cancer is basically an uncontrolled division of cells or tissues, or you can say cancer is mitosis run amok. So more than a million India suffers from cancer, and large number of them die from it annually. The mechanisms that underlie the development of cancer or oncogenic transformation of cells, its treatment and control have been some of the most intense areas of research in biology and medicine. In our body, the cell growth and differentiation, which occurs in most of the cells, is highly controlled and regulated action. But in case of cancer cells, what happens? There is a breakdown of these regulatory mechanisms. Most of the normal cells, they exhibit a property which is known as contact inhibition, by virtue of which contact with other cells inhibit their uncontrolled growth, which doesn't happen in case of cancer cells. So cancer cells appears to have lost this property. As a result of this, cancer cells just continue to divide, giving rise to the mass of cells, which results into the formation of tumors. So tumors are basically classified into two categories. Tumors may develop anywhere on or in the body. However, all tumors are not cancerous. So let's see what are the two types of cancer. The first one is benign, or also known as non-malignant tumor. It grows slowly, may attain quite a large size, but it remains confined to a site of its origin and does not spread to the other parts of the body. This does not necessarily mean that the benign tumors are not troublesome. Growth of a tumor may cause crowding of other organs, resulting in pain. A brain tumor may cause death because the brain is squeeze against the underlying skull. Moreover, the benign tumors may sometimes become malignant. This is why they are often removed when discovered. Now, the second form or the second type of tumor is a cancerous form of tumor, which is also known as malignant tumor. It first grows slowly. No symptoms are noticeable at this stage, which is known as the latent stage, the tumor later grows rapidly. The cancerous cells compete with the normal cells for nutrition and finally kill them. Rapid growth of tumor causes overcrowding and disruption of the normal cells. Still later, it extends to the neighboring tissues like the roots of a tree. At the last stage, bits of tumor tissues breaks off and are carried by the circulating blood or lymph to the other parts of the body, where they invade new tissues. This process is known as metastasis. It is observed only in case of malignant tumor, which is the property of malignant tumors. Metastasis is basically characteristics of a cancerous tumor, and it distinguishes it from benign tumor. Cancerous cells are known to be less sticky than normal cells, and this may account for their tendency to break away from the tumor. Reaching a new tissue, the bits continue to grow and form secondary tumors. The later interface or the later interferes with the normal functioning of the affected tissue. The last stage is called the metastasia, ultimately causing the death of the victim due to the increased interference with the body life processes. So let's see what are the causes of cancer. Basically, transformation of normal cells into cancerous neoplastic cells may be induced either by physical, chemical or biological agents. These agents are known as carcinogens. Ionizing radiations like X-rays, gamma rays and non-ionizing radiations like ultraviolet rays cause DNA damage, leading to the neoplastic transformation. The chemical carcinogens present in tobacco smoke have been identified as the major cause of lung cancer. In case of biological category, we have cancer-causing viruses called oncogenic viruses, which have genes known as viral oncogenes. Furthermore, several genes called cellular oncogenes or C-onc, or also known as proto-oncogenes, have been identified in normal cells, which when activated under certain condition could lead to oncogenic transformation of the cells. Let's see how cancer is being detected and what are the diagnostic methods. The early detection of cancer is essential as it allows the disease to be treated successfully in many cases. Cancer detection is based on biopsy and histopathological studies of the tissue and blood, and also of the bone marrow test for increased cell counts in the case of leukemias. In biopsy, a piece of suspected tissue cut into thin sections is stained and examined under a microscope. Histopathological studies, which include blood samples and tissues, are identified by the pathologist. Techniques like X-ray, CT scan, that is computed tomography, and MRI, magnetic resonance imaging, are also very useful to detect cancers of internal organs. Computed tomography uses X-ray to generate the 3D image of the internal organs of an object. MRI uses strong magnetic field and non-ionizing radiations to accurately detect the pathological and physiological changes in the living tissues. Another very important molecular biological test is antibody antigen reaction test, which also helps in detecting the cancer specific antigens to identify the cancer present in the body of the victim. So when molecular techniques are applied to detect the genes in an individual with the inherited susceptibility to certain cancers, identification of such genes which predispose an individual to certain cancer may be very helpful in prevention of cancer. Such individuals may be advised to avoid exposure to the particular carcinogen to which they are susceptible, example tobacco smoke in case of lung cancer. Let's see what are the treatment available for the cancer. The common approaches for treatment of cancer are basically the surgery, radiation therapy and immunotherapy. In radiation therapy, tumor cells are irradiated lethally, taking proper care of the normal tissues surrounding the tumor mass. Several chemotherapy drugs are also used to kill cancerous cells. Some of these are specific for particular tumors. Majority of the drugs have side effects like hair loss, anemia, etc. Most cancers are treated by combination of surgery, radiotherapy and chemotherapy. Tumor cells have been shown to avoid detection and destruction by immune system. Therefore, the patients are given substances called biological response modifiers such as alpha interferons, which activates their immune system and helps in destroying the tumor. Thank you.